melon field was all lit up for night picking, for harvest, with little lights that looked like a loner's semaphore from far away. Elvis walked through the field cursing his broken truck. He was still dead, and he had a body full of new tattoos. He drove a truck now and was searching for the ghost of his dead twin, Jesse. He figured Jesse's ghost had to be somewhere between Tupelo and Memphis, and he would search every shadow in every bus. He would search the cab of every Peterbilt truck and the ice shadow of every moon. And if it felt like rain, he would search the pines and the cottonwoods, the culverts and under bridges. Elvis looked down at the red mud around his feet. It was as red and warm as the blood of the soldiers and slaves that died here. Mud for growing and dying for, the bloody cradle and mother of the South. Elvis touched the inky flags on his chest. He still had yellow welts around the stripes, and the stars were still bright white. He rubbed his nipples, still sore from the needles. He stared off at the DeSoto Bridge, the 2 miles of steel girders and loops that link Memphis to Arkansas like mother and child. He would not go near Memphis, not even to peek into the window of the Hideaway or Sun Records. Not even to rub his hand on the stone of his mother's grave. Not even to see his Cadillacs, airplanes, or his old Les Paul. He wanted only to find Jesse's ghost, and to reach out across the whistling miles and graves between them. Elvis felt the wind and fireflies waft through him. He heard the far-off music of crickets and toads, greyhounds and combine tractors, of crop dusters and burning leaves. Dragonflies and swaying signs he heard long ago choruses from slave ships and gospels singing their way onto the field on the wavy grain stalks. He felt Jesse in the moaning night's chill, his other half close as skin and common as dirt. Elvis stuck the end of a weed in his mouth and squinted his eyes reading the melon field, searching its darknesses for the shadow he'd waited his whole life and death for. The ghost of a slave found him and took his hand. In it he pushed a cotton spur and closed Elvis's fist until the spur drew blood. The blood flowed out, slow and sickly, yellow and thick. The ghost squeezed and the poison blood was gone. The ghost washed Elvis with his spit and tears. He handed Elvis an infant. Elvis looked at Jesse, the memory of his kindest mirror. He sat in the melon field with Jesse cradled in his arms and told him everything. The honky-tonks, the cars, the women, the painkillers, the Cadillacs, the midnights, the movies, the hotels, the gold and the heartbreak. Elvis told Jesse of their mother and the quilt she made, the red patches, the silver trim, the blue patches and the cross stitches, and the pieces of yarn too short to save and too beautiful to throw away.